California versus Texas theme of late, especially with President Obama going to Texas tomorrow to tout job creation. Even former California Assemblyman Chuck DeVore is comparing the two states. He says, if California eliminated its state income tax, just got rid of it, its taxes would still be higher than Texas. Mr. DeVore is now with the Texas Public Policy Foundation, and he joins us now. Chuck, welcome to the program. I can't believe this. If California got rid of entirely its income tax, state income tax, they'd still be more heavily taxed than Texas. Explain that one to us.
Well, it was amazing to me, but Stuart, one of the themes that I've been hearing recently after I moved from California to Texas is that, well, Texas can afford to tax less because they've got all that oil and gas, and that's really what pays for government. Well, I looked into the numbers, and oil and gas severance revenues, severance taxes, fund a little less than 4% of Texas state and local government. Now, of course, California has a lot of oil, too, over 15 billion barrels in the Monterey Shale Formation. That's something like two-thirds of America's proven oil shale reserves. It's just that they don't let it come out of the ground, and if they did, they'd want to tax it more. So, you know, I looked into it, and I found out that California taxes about 42% more of the share of state income than does Texas. And so California completely eliminated its state income tax with the highest tax bracket in America, it would still take about 4% more of its people's income than is the case in Texas.
So you moved to Texas. I remember you came on the show and told us about that. I take it that you like it. You settled in okay, have you?
Texas is the land of liberty and freedom, and that is why so many people are voting with their feet and moving to Texas. You know, the president is going to be here in Austin tomorrow.
Yeah.
And one of the things that I've looked up just yesterday is that since he has become president, Texas, compared to California, as a proportion of the population in each state, has produced more than 10 times the amount of jobs as has California.
Well,
10 times.
Why is the president going to Texas? Okay, Austin is something of a liberal bastion in the great state of Texas. I understand that. But why is he going to Texas, the land of free enterprise, liberty, and individual freedom, and he's going to push that message of government? It must be government is the agent of change. Government is the one that will give us more jobs. Why is he doing this?
Well, I think because the press is obligated to cover what he says, and what he wants to do is create these centrally planned industrial hubs. He wants to raise the national minimum wage to $9 an hour. He wants to spend more money. And the thing that's important to understand is you have two models, the two biggest states where one-fifth of Americans live, very similar in size, very similar in demographics, very different in their governance. California takes 42% more of its income of the people than is the case in Texas. And if you look at the new U.S. Census Bureau figures for poverty in America, these figures take into account the cost of living and the value of social welfare programs. What you'll see is that California also has 42% more of its people in poverty than does Texas. So it isn't working. The Obama model is the California way. The Texas model is the free market way. It is not what the president is advocating.
All right, Chuck DeVore, happy in Texas. Thank you very much for joining us, sir. Appreciate it. Thank you.